Hello everyone, my name is Prithviraj. This is the fourth video on ALP programming for ARM 7. In this video, we are going to study some more new instruction, and if time permits, we will take up a program example. So let's start. This is where we left in the previous video. In this video, we are going to take up new instruction called as ASR, that is arithmetic shift right. The syntax of arithmetic shift right instruction is this one. This is one of the syntax. Now I will show you how to look for the syntax in the manual. The manual link will be in the description box below. Now I will open the manual for ARM 7. This is the manual. Here all the instructions are arranged alphabetically. To search ASR, we have to look it in alphabetical order. On scrolling down, arithmetic shift right syntax has been given here. This is the first syntax which I have wrote here, and this will be the second syntax which I will be taking up now. This is how you look for the syntaxes in the manual. So let me give an example for this one. This was where we left. I will create a new file over here. I will cancel this over here and delete this one. The new text file has been created. Now I am going to type the code as an example for ASR, arithmetic shift right. Remember, the caps lock should be on, and I will give the file name in small letter. I'm going to save this as asr.save. I have saved this, and I'm going to add this one to the source group. Right click on source group, add, and click here and select this as .s, and here you have asr. Add, close. The file has been added to the source group. Now I'm going to compile this. Zero errors and zero warnings. Now I will explain this code for you. ASR is arithmetic shift right. This is exactly same as LSR. The only difference is the sign of the number is retained. In the case of LSR, it is logical shift right. Every bit is shifted to the right. But in the case of ASR, the most significant bit, that is MSB, is retained, which means that the sign of the bit is retained. Let me compile this and take an example of minus 10, then you will understand it clearly. When LSR was used, it was like divide the number by 2. In ASR also, it is same. Let me show you. I start the debug session, F11. 10 has been decoded as A, that is hexadecimal, and after dividing, and when we shift it to the right, it will be divided by 2. And 5 will be stored in R2. See, this is exactly the same as LSR. But the significance of ASR can be seen when the negative numbers are used. I will stop the debug session. Now I will use here minus 10. The equivalent of minus 10 in decimal is nothing but 1010. That is 8 plus 2, 10. 1010. This is for positive. And for negative, this negative sign is added if it is 5-bit number. Since our ARM is 32-bit number, as the sign extension, all the remaining bits are taken as 1 as the sign extension, which means this will be the case. This is the 10, and this is the MSB bit, which signifies the negative part, signifies that the number is negative. As the sign extension, all the 1 has been extended till here. So this will be, this is binary. This is converted into hexa, that is F, 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 and some value over here. This is minus 10. I have saved this. I will compile and I will start the debug session. When I press F11, You can see your R1 value is FFFF6, that is minus 10. When I again press F11, you can see here 6 FFFF6 is minus 10 and this is minus 5, which looks like this, that this is equal to minus 5. Similarly, like this. This is the phi, representing phi, and this all is the sine extension of negative. This is how it looks. So I'm going to stop the debug session, and you can check with other numbers also. Let me take it as minus 4. I'm going to save it, start the debug session. Stop the debug session now. I have to compile this, then start the debug session. Press F11. Minus 4 has been stored, and press F11 again. Minus 2 has been stored over here. Minus 2 will be something like this. That is 1, 0. This will be the minus 2, which is given here in hexa value. This was one of the variation in the ASR. There is another variation also, that is ASR RD, RS. This is exactly the same as that of LSR. It has same syntax as LSR and same limitations as LSR, which I have told you in the previous video. And I think I have missed to say that the limitation of loading the register, here you can see that the loading the register, the maximum limit is minus 2 raised to 31 to 2 raised to 31 minus 1, that is for signed value. And for unsigned, it is 2 raised to 32 minus 1. That is, I am going to write it over here. Minus 2 raised to 31 to 2 raised to 31 minus 1. This is for signed number. And for the unsigned number, it is 2 raised to 32 minus 1. Since the positive signed number is considered as unsigned, you can take this as the highest number for the positive and this as the lowest number that LDR instruction can take as negative. This was the second syntax I was talking about. This is same as that of LSR. You can try it on your own. If there are any doubts about this, leave the comment in the comment section. I will definitely discuss on that. Now we will go in detail about some of the things in InKill software, which we have not touched in the previous video. So when I have saved this and I start the debug session, and here you can see, this is known as disassembly. Here, whatever code you write is decoded in the ARM language, means in which the ARM understands. That is, you can see here, this LDR R1 minus 1. This is the address in which this instruction is stored, and this is LDR is decoded as the value given over here, hexa value, and the R1 comma equal to minus 4 has been decoded as R1 bracket PC. Here ASR R2 R1 hash 1 has been decoded as mov R2 R1 comma ASR hash 1. You can also use this type of instructions while writing. This type of instruction we will see in upcoming videos. This is used to reduce the number of lines, means you can perform two instructions at a time. This is one of the variations, that is R1 arithmetic shift write of R1 one time and store it in R2. Now I am going to stop the debug session. Now I am going to show one interesting thing over here. I will put here LDR and give the value as 4. I am going to save this, compile this and start debug session. Here you can see I have given here LDR, but the compiler has taken it as mov, because any LDR instruction which is within the mov range is taken as mov. The range of mov has been discussed in the previous videos. Whichever value you give to LDR which is in the range of mov is always decoded as mov itself. If I am going to exceed the range of mov instruction, then it is taken as LDR itself. This is where the mov instruction range is exceeded, 257. I am going to save this, compile this, debug. Here you can see that LDR is taken as LDR itself, because It has this R1 comma equal to 257 exceeded the range of move instruction. So it is treated as LDR now. This is called as disassembly section. These are all the addresses where these instructions are stored. At location 0x000, this instruction has been stored. At the location 4, this instruction has been stored. I am going to stop the debug session. Now we will look into one more instruction called as ROR, that is rotate right. And one more thing I have forgot to tell you, that there is only arithmetic shift right. There is no such instruction as arithmetic shift left. You can also see in the manual that there is only arithmetic shift right, and there is no arithmetic shift left instruction in the ARM, and it applies to rotate also. There is only rotate right, and there is no such instruction as rotate left. So this is the syntax of rotate right. Now I'm going to give an example for this. Let this be 2, and this is the example. We'll see how does this work. I'm going to save it, compile it, start the debug session. Press F11. 2 has been stored, and I will do F11 again. 1 has been stored. This is same as that of LSR and ASR for unsigned numbers. That is division by 2. Rotate is nothing but, let me show you over here. The equivalent of 2 in binary is this one. When I say rotate right, it is nothing but the last bit is taken from here and is given over here. That is, 0 comes from here and will be given over here for first rotation. When we do second rotation, 1 which has been shifted over here will be taken and given at the MSB side. Let us see that. I am going to stop the debug session. This is nothing but, here this is the destination and this is the source itself, and this is the number of times the action should occur. That is, the number in R1 is taken and is rotated, and the number of times is specified in R2. Now we will see the output of this. I am going to save this, compile this, start the debug session. F11, 2 has been stored. 2 has been stored for R2, and again press F11. R1 is rotated 2 times and 8 has occurred here. In the previous one, I have forgot to press F11 once again. That is, if it was 1, I am going to compile this, start the debug session. The value of R1 has been stored here, and F11, the value of R2 has been stored. When I give F11 again, R1 is rotated 1 time and 1 is stored in R1 itself. I am going to stop the debug session. This I have forgot to tell you. I stopped here. Now I stop the debug session. I think you have seen this one, like 2 times rotate 2 times. I want to save this, compile this, start the debug session. F11, 2 has been stored in R1. F11, again the 2 has been stored in R2. When I press again F11, R1 value is rotated 2 times, which becomes this one. That is, over here you can see this one will be taken from, shifted 1 time will come here, and that one will be taken here, and this zeros will be, all zeros will be moved to the right. At that time it becomes 800000, which is given over here, 800000. So this was about the rotate instruction. From this video onwards, the instructions are enough. From next video, we will take up the examples and we will solve them on the fly. We will learn some of the instructions. So this is it for this video. I have not covered ASRS, that is putting S at the end of ASR, arithmetic shift right. This has been explained in the reference of LSR in the previous video, that is logical shift right. You can refer that and you can do this on your own. Adding S at the end will affect the carry flag. So if you are not able to understand that, leave a comment in the comment section. I will make a video on it. And please do subscribe and like the video, which will encourage me to do more videos and new series. See you in next video. Bye.